this is held together, the seam here is held together by these boards. No real need to put screws on either side of the seam, especially when there's a window here. Now, I don't know what else is holding this together. I'm going to get my flat bar and see if I can tell if the wall is separated or not. I believe it is. I don't know what's holding that. Glue? Did they glue that? Looks like we did. Looks like it got glued. Or is this more nails that I haven't seen? Like that one. Well, that was a screw when we got it out. So it just got stuck, I guess. Yeah. Stuff is just stuck. Well, there's a few heads. This one. No. Not sure. Let's see what happens. Not sure how this is going to work, but let's see what happens. That's not all we can do, really. Okay, this side is separated. So is this side. All right. We're gonna lay it down. It seems to be still attached right here somehow. We can lay that wall over now. So this system seems to be working pretty good. Here we go. What do you think of that? Finally hurt myself and now I'm bleeding. Get it over with early in the week. But there is the first half of the curbside wall. Now we'll go get that side down, do it the exact same way. All right, through the jiggle method that I spoke about before, which basically you're just wiggling and maybe prying a little bit like this, you'll find nails that still need to be pulled. But I thought I got them all, what we needed, but I'm seeing that we have some more. So you have, during disassembly, This is called disassembly and discovery. And while disassembling, you find how everything is assembled. So from what I can see, there's not much left. It's holding this thing on from what I can see, just along the bottom there mostly. And maybe one or two nails that I'm not seeing. Like right here where this is, I've got some nails nailed sideways into a strip, a cleat in here. That's the same problem I had on the other side where they double nailed. They've gone in from one way and then the other. But I'm just pulling those nails with it. So we'll see that when we get it more apart. I'm going to go ahead and get the two uprights screwed to this now so that the whole thing doesn't just drop. And do the same thing that we did to the other side. This side has more cabinets involved, so it's taking a little bit more time to disassemble it. But like I say, you got to do it piece by piece, screw by screw, nail by nail. And it's the same with a framed wall. Except for the framed wall, you can see everything. Once you remove the metal skin, you can see just about everything from both sides, how you have to do it. Okay, now it's very important to keep this wall intact in the shape that it's in so I can exactly reproduce it. So I want to keep, see this section here with the bottom of the door is not very stable, and I want to make sure and keep the two door jambs exactly the same distance apart. So I'm going to put four screws in here to hold it there, because then I'm going to disconnect these legs from the whole piece, stand it up and move it out of the way up against the wall there, and bring down the other side. They have there. Now that's going to hold the door apart at the exact right position. And now I can disconnect these legs from the wall and stand the wall up and get it out of my way. So, just a matter of climbing underneath, undoing the screws. All right, now we'll continue to take the screws out. There it is. One down, one to go. Yeah, I might want to do a little bit of prying in there. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Between the cabinet and the wall. I'm inside the cabinet here next to the wheel well, which is right here. You can see there's just a little bit more there, right there. where it needs to be separated. There's the outside. And I'm gonna give it a little bit of a pry just to see what happens. I don't want to hurt the cabinet. Yeah, it's coming. All right, so, and that crunching you hear is just, again, places where things are still a little bit held together. All right, so let's go back outside now. All right, before I go back outside, I'm doing this too. There, see? I got daylight down there. Just getting it separated. It's coming.
All right, here we go. Let's see what happens. When it all stays together. Ooh. Happens pretty easily, huh? Needs a little bit of coaxing. What did it? Let's see what's holding it now. What? There's a lot of sawdust and stuff in here. Wow. All right, here we go. Gonna lay this down. It's working out really nice, the way I had hoped it would. So I'm gonna leave it angled like this. There it is. This wall is done. There. You can lay it down. Yeah. That seemed pretty simple. That one foot keeps wanting to bend on me. I guess I should have put some angle braces on there. There it is. So I'm just going to do the same thing with this. I'm going to unscrew it. I'll prop it up on the horses and unscrew it and plop it up against the wall.
Let's take a look in here. I want you to see something. That's all sawdust. And that sawdust has been in there for, well, since 1947. And I think they just put it in there as part of the insulation for the icebox, which is right there. They stuffed all that in there and then filled the top up with insulation or with sawdust and put sawdust in the bottom. Yeah, they did everything as cheaply as possible back then. I'm gonna clean all that out. But there she is. Curbside. All opened up, naked trailer. Just the guts. The other wall is next.